Hello. You might have seen clocks like this at a train station before, and notice that there's a short pause between the second hand reaching 12 and the minute hand advancing. Strictly speaking, these aren't quite clocks, they're actually secondary clocks, and the delay is the time between the second hand doing a full rotation, about 58.5 seconds, and the secondary clock receiving an electrical pulse from the mother clock. The pulse advances the minute hand and sets the seconds hand free again. These old clocks are lovely, but without the mother clock's pulse, all the secondary clocks are just ornaments. We wanted an old-fashioned train station clock, so we bought one off eBay. Now we just needed to buy or build a mother clock if we wanted it to measure the time. So we decided to build one. A microcomputer with an internet connection would be overkill, so we've used a microcontroller listening to a radio signal instead. For a few euros, you can get a ferrite antenna that can pick up longwave radio. Attach the antenna to a Raspberry Pi Pico and we're in business. Just outside of Frankfurt in Germany, there's some radio masts that have been constantly transmitting the DCF-77 radio signal since 1973. DCF-77 is a longwave radio transmission that broadcasts the official German time as reported by atomic clocks, and is accurate to about a second every 300,000 years. The signal travels thousands of kilometres and covers most of Europe. DCF-77 is a series of long and short pulses that follow a quiet second. This marks the 59th second in a minute, announcing that a new time is about to be broadcast. The pulses represent bits of data that can be assembled to figure out the time. We wrote some code. It receives the DCF-77 signal, waits for a second, and then gets to work. It measures the length of each pulse and then converts that into ones or zeros. If the code passes a couple of checks to make sure the string is valid, we have a 58-digit number that contains the time. Now that we've made something that can receive the time, we just need to send a 24-volt pulse to the clock every time a new minute passes. For a bit of insurance, we've attached a real-time clock to the Pico, so it doesn't need to rely on the radio signal all the time. We've made it so the clock checks in with the radio tower daily, but generally relies on the Pico's accurate real-time clock. The code we've used is on GitHub. It's work in progress, so if you can improve it, feel free to submit a pull request. Here it is in action.